today I'm going to start the process of respraying the outside of my subwoofer enclosure with Raptor Bed Liner. Also, my final 1-inch thick acrylic window is being cut right now. Spoiler alert, it turned out perfect just like I said it would in the last video. We already counted that for a win last night. I'm not bragging, I just want to let those of you know who are keeping score that you don't have to change anything in your record book. You could leave it at 135% success rate. You don't have to touch a thing. Wait till you see it. Amplifiers produced by Soundman Enterprises Inc., Mobile Solutions, CT Sounds, and Extreme Auto Sports. Before I can spray any bed liner, I need to set up my paint booth. The Raptor bed liner takes about 60 minutes to set. Overspray gets everywhere and the fumes are really strong. Last time I sprayed Raptor bed liner in the shop without a paint booth, I breathed in a lot of bed liner overspray. And let me tell you, it really sticks to your ribs. I'm still suffering from black lung. My friend's mom has black throat. It's not to be confused with. It's different. It's not what you think. You may think it's a coal miner's disease. Black throat is a loose neck from gorking a lot of black dicks in a row. Too many in a row.
Why don't you shut the fuck up right now, seriously?
But it's really not that bad, I don't mind it. God damn, look at this paint booth. Shit. Son of a shit-eating fat bitch. God damn. This looks like I'm about to try and one-up a Logan Paul video. He filmed a dead dude in the forest. I'm gonna gut a human live on YouTube. And by gut a human, I mean blow my ass out when I try to lift the box out. I'm gonna prolapse my taint.
Yo, what the f- actually?
I'm gonna inside out myself trying to lift this box. It's never been done before on YouTube. And to think my mom thought I would never pull my head out of my ass. I might do it today. The final window is almost done. While I'm waiting, I could paint the inner lip tan to match the birch interior. Once this window lip is painted, I can verify that the window is perfect like I said it was going to be. Then I need to sand the box down, clean it really well, and try to get one bottle of Raptor liner sprayed on the back and bottom before I leave for the day. Now this is the moment of truth. It fucked up at the last minute. Just kidding. I already said it was perfect. In the last video, I said it was gonna be... I already told you.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
Now I have a fresh 1-inch thick acrylic window. I'll just need to polish the edges before I mount it in the box. This is looking pretty good. I need to repair one busted out corner with some 3M plastic epoxy. Then I need to mask off the rear openings and this thing is ready to spray. Now I have to sand down the entire surface of the box so the new coat of bed liner will adhere to the surface. A lot of people in the comments say you can't put a new coat of bed liner over an old coat of bed liner. It's gonna pop off when the bass hits. You have to strip the old bed liner off. Or else it's ruined. I kinda think you can. There's only three ways to find out. We could have either taken the extra time and sprayed a test piece, or we could just sacrifice it and just hit the box, see what happens. And if it's fucked up, we could start over. Or you could read the website. It says you could spray over old epoxy bed liners. You just have to sand it down and clean it. So before you leave a comment, Russell, you should read the website before you leave a stupid comment. I bet he posted the comment before I was finished. Russell, you dumb shit. Didn't you learn your lesson from last time? What an idiot. And then it happened. The box tipped over and I blew my ass out. All that work and nothing happened. Except I shit the fuck out of my pants. Right now I'm hitting a couple edges with some trim black and prepping the entire back and bottom, and I'll spray that today. That'll have 2 full days to dry. The next time I can prep the front and put a nice thick coat on the front. I plan on unloading a full bottle of Raptor Bedliner on the back and bottom today, and next time I want to bust 2 bottles on the face of the box. After the box has been sitting in the truck for a month, you can see that the material did shrink, and there are a couple spots where the bedliner seems really thin. So this time I want to try to build the bedliner up as thick as I possibly can. And then I can drop test it off the roof of the shop. After all this prep, it's time to spray it. I'm trying to be serious and get ready, and now I dropped my ear pod down my leg. I have to undress, take my clothes off. I dropped my earbud. I like this Raptor liner kit. It's super easy to use. It comes with the gun, separated out into 4 bottles, and you just pour the hardener into one of the bottles up to the line, shake it up really well, and it's ready to use. My milkshake brings all the boys to the dog. So far, this looks really good. This is about half a bottle. Ooh, all this bed liner is really gonna hold the bass in, you know? This looks great. This will have 2 full days to dry. Then I could flip it over, spray the front. Then all I'll have to do is mount the stainless steel top and put everything back together. Thank you guys so much for always watching. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think about today's episode. I'll see you guys next time. Support Amplified by buying iPad dash kits and Soundman merch at soundmanca.com. Become a car audio master with the tools and trainings available for mobile solutions at mobilesolutions-usa.com. Receive a discount on all the best car audio equipment from CT Sounds by using coupon code SOUNDMAN at ctsounds.com. And come down to see me and Rafa at Extreme Autosports in Santa Clarita and get great deals on audio and performance equipment and installation.